American Express. Jim, very nice to have you with us tonight.
Nice to be here, Mike.
You go back a few years with hockey, and as a matter of fact, we asked you to bring some relics from your office. We've seen them over there at your American Express office, and this hockey stick goes back to the 20s.
Yeah, this hockey stick was used by my wife's uncle in 1924 and 1925. Significance of that is he played with the same stick for 2 years.
For 2 years. Now these guys go into it and play with them for about half a game and then lose it.
Well, we had five sons, three of whom were skaters, and they went through a dozen of sticks every 2 weeks.
There were different rules in those days. What could you tell us about it? No slap shots?
Well, there were no slap shots, and there were no deflections. You could not score a goal from a deflection. And when I used this other artifact to play goal, it was a lot simpler game.
You were a goalie, and hold that glove up there so folks can see, because the glove that is being used nowadays is quite a bit larger than this one, Jim.
Yeah, it is substantially larger. Too bad we didn't have one to show you. But this worked very well in the time that I had to use it. Without slap shots, not that hard to... I shouldn't say it was not that hard, but it seemed not to be that hard.
Well, and no masks either in the old days.
No masks, that's where that hole is from.
You got a little indentation in your forehead. You were raised on the East Coast, and so you played hockey in the backyard and outside in those days.
Well, yeah, as soon as it got too cold to play baseball, they flooded the baseball field, and we skated every afternoon, 7 days a week, for probably 3 months.
A lot of folks in the Intermountain West, even though we have this beautiful weather out here and a lot of skiing and a lot of ice skating inside, don't realize that those of us who grew up in the Midwest actually flooded our backyards and really got out there and got after the hockey. And so we learned how to skate at a young age.
Yeah, we did. And in addition to being able to skate on a baseball field or in a backyard, you could skate on lakes and ponds and up streams. And you could go for miles on a pair of skates.
You know, there are a lot of folks who talk about hockey, professional hockey, and we've been around here for 22 years, but I think there's a misconception. I think a lot of people think that the professional hockey is kind of a blue-collar game, and that's really not true, is it, Jim?
Well, I don't think so. Back when I was playing, the kids that I played with in college were certainly guys who grew up to be in the business kind of world that I'm at. I went to the Bruins games for probably 20 years or 25 years or so, and I wouldn't call that a blue-collar crowd. Difference is I think they knew a lot more about what was going on in the breakout plays and in the blocks that they play in defense and things of that nature. I think the biggest issue here is that most people don't understand what it is that's going on out there.
And they're learning by watching the game tonight, Jim, as the Golden Eagles really set up a pretty big win here. Mr. Jim Welch from American Express, thank you very much for being with us. And let's go back to the KXIV studios. Thank you very much. Okay, Brian, you want me no more until the end of the game, right? Okay.
Face off. Welcome to the IHL. Welcome to the minors. welcome back to the Salt Palace here in Salt Lake City, Utah. I'm Mike Barak, and the Salt Lake Golden Eagles, with two more goals in the second period, have increased their lead from 4-1 to 6-1. Randy Busick, the Golden Eagles, outstanding in that period. They outshot the Wings 23-7, and have 38 shots so far in two periods of play.
Boy, they really are continuing to pour the pressure on the Wings through a great forecheck and a lot of great playmaking, Mike.
It is an outstanding night for the fans here in Salt Lake. The Eagles scored twice in the second period, and the first one on a deflection.
Well, great face-off by Todd Harkins to get it back to Darrell Olsen, who rips a slap shot, but Deasley's right there to tip it past Larry Dick as he was moving the other way.
And that made the score 5-1 in favor of the Salt Lake Golden Eagles. The Golden Eagles looking for their sixth goal in the second period.
Well, Rich Chinnamaz picks up the puck here, goes flying down the wing. The defenseman is worried about he's going to drop the pass, but he quickly snaps one past the far side of Larry Dick. Perhaps surprised him, Mike.
Well, Rich Chinnamaz on his off wing, of course, being a right-handed shot, really surprised Dick as he was working down that off wing.
Well, he had a couple of options there, and he really utilized them and really tricked the goaltender by snapping a quick one past him.
Well, of course, Randy, the Golden Eagles scored four in the first period, the two goals in the second, and the Golden Eagles having the lead 5-1 as Brian Deasley scored on the deflection at 2:28. Darrell Olsen and Mark Bureau on the assist. Rick Lessard and Kerry Clark on the assist to the Chernomaz goal at 16:05, and that's the way the game stands right now, 6-1 in favor of the Salt Lake Golden Eagles. Randy, what do we look for in period three?
Well, I think that the Wings aren't really playing that bad. Although the score is 6-1, they've had a lot of great opportunities. Larry Dick is still hanging in there tough, making some big saves. Although Warren Sharples hasn't had as much work as him, has also played outstanding for the Golden Eagles. I suspect that's still a fast-paced game because the Wings aren't a team to give up.
The Golden Eagles up 6-1. We're going to go down ice level with the Eagles up by 5.
Well, thank you very much, Mike Barak, and Randy Busick calling the play-by-play upstairs. And C.J. Young, a rookie out of Harvard University in his first year with the Golden Eagles. And C.J., you got the night off, but you're seeing some pretty exciting hockey tonight.
Oh, it's a great game. We're really playing well offensively, and I think maybe Kalamazoo's a little bit worn out. And we're putting the puck away, which is good to see. I mean, our defense is solid, and when you let up less than two goals a game, you're really doing something for the club. So hopefully we can keep it going.
Your first year as a professional out of college, you've graduated from Harvard University. Yes. In economics?
History major, American history.
What do you plan to do after you get out of professional hockey? We're talking about 20, 30 years down the road.
Yeah, it's too hard to tell. I'm going to right now just concentrate on my hockey, and hopefully it'll take me pretty good into the future, and we'll take it from there.
You had an unusual way of getting into professional hockey. You really were unsigned, basically, coming out of college, and Calgary basically took a chance on you, and here you are.
Right. Yeah, I was. I came out in the spring, graduated in June, and I was drafted in the supplemental round by New Jersey. But we had complications about training camp, and if they were going to sign me or not. And Calgary had come to Harvard a few times. They've had numerous draft picks from that school, and I guess they like what they saw a few times and decided to take a chance, and I'm fortunate to be in this organization.
Well, we're fortunate to have you here in Salt Lake, CJ. We're really enjoying your first year of play and looking forward to making up to Calgary.
That sounds great. Thanks, Mike.
CJ Young with the Golden Eagles, a rookie, and going to show an awful lot on Salt Palace ice. Now let's go back up to Mike Barak and Randy Busick.
Thanks, Mike. The Golden Eagles up 6-1, and C.J. Young out of the lineup tonight. The Eagles have four extra bodies.
Well, Bobby Francis has a very tough decision. He's got four extra players right now, and he has a luxury of inserting a lot of fresh players throughout this last little stint of the schedule.
And it's worked out. The Golden Eagles have been playing great. It is 6-1 after two periods, and we'll come back in just a moment for the third period here at the Salt Palace.
Phoenix 3, San Diego 2. And in Kansas City at Kemper Arena in the third period, it's Kansas City 4, Fort Wayne 1. 4-1 Kansas City leading Fort Wayne. The Golden Eagles would like to welcome to the Salt Palace for tonight's game a special group from Midwest Floor Coverings.
Also some birthday wishes for you. Happy birthday to Joyce Tuchel. And a happy 25th birthday to Mr. Chris.
I was worried because I met her the other day. letters on the game. Like no idea. Which she wanted an extra ticket to bring a friend. She brought a girl,
though. She wants to pawn her friend off on you, that's right.
Hey, good job, man. It's sounding, what do you think?
Good.
Sounding.
Ryan, how's that sound? Smooth up there?
And happy birthday to Kristen Silver. Kristen Silver celebrating her day. And a lot of friends up there. And also a birthday wish going out to Jared Bates. Jared Bates, happy birthday. And now, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back. Yours, the Golden Eagles.
At 3 points. Everyone to the Salt Palace, the Golden Eagles, six different goal scorers tonight of a five-goal cushion, a 6-1 advantage over the Kalamazoo Wings through two periods of play, and Salt Lake looking for their 38th win of the season, and Randy, they look good for their 13th win in February. They are 12-0-1, and this month they have not lost in the second month of the calendar year.
Well, an absolutely amazing feat that they have accomplished throughout February. To go really undefeated with only that one overtime loss, but this team is really firing on all pistons, Mike.
Golden Eagles, Bob Francis has to be pleased. The head coach, always serious, even with his team up five goals. He doesn't want to see any kind of a collapse in this third period, so the Golden Eagles, I'm sure, will come out flying in period three.
Well, I'm sure that in between the periods, he told the players, look, we've got six goals. We don't really need any more to win. But let's keep that one on the board for the Wings. Let's not let them get any more goals. Take pride in our defense, and let's start playing for Warren Sharples.
John Marks for Kalamazoo, his team down by five. They lost 7-3 Tuesday night. What's he thinking about?
Well, perhaps he could be thinking about tomorrow. This is an important period for them because they play this Eagles team tomorrow back in Kalamazoo. So it could be for them a little bit of a momentum builder. Get a good period, put this one behind them, and work for tomorrow night.
The Golden Eagles and the Kalamazoo Wings, 6,656. Randy, great crowd here tonight at the Salt Palace.
Well, and they're really enjoying a lot of action here. The Eagles are really throwing some goals in the net, and they've seen some superb goaltending too.
But here we go. The Eagles up by five and control the puck. And Darryl Olsen on the right side. Samar to head for Mark Giroux into the wing zone. Tries to center one to black off on the left wing side. And Larry DePalma able to leave it to three for Gary Emmett. Drops it back for Peter Lappin. His shot. Sharples gets a piece and he falls back on top as Lappin continues to fire from all distances. And Sharples continues to have all the answers.
Well, Sharples is very sharp here. Lappin gets a puck and just rips one with traffic in front of Sharples. Sharples is able to grab the puck and hold on to the rebound.
Sharples has not lost at the Salt Palace since November 29th. It's the Golden Eagles, of course, outstanding when leading through two periods of play. Only one regulation loss.
Well, a lot of times the goaltenders will credit their good play to the defense in front of them, but really Warren Sharples should take a lot of that credit himself, and so should Steve Gannett. Both goaltenders have been absolutely outstanding for this Eagles team.
Richard Zemlak for Salt Lake draws up for the Eagles, plays it for Kevin Grant to the left of the goal. At the Eagles with a five-goal cushion and control the puck in their own end. Kevin Grant able to play it free into center ice. Corey Lyons trying to chip it for Paul Cruz. And the Eagles rookie, he's only 20 years of age, able to play into the defense. Two 20-year-olds on the line now for Salt Lake with Cruz and Lyons, the veteran Zemlak in the middle. As Kevin Melrose plays the puck for the Salt Lake Golden Eagles out of Harvard University, where C.J. Young also played at that school. Here's the Corey Lyons racing in after it, trying to poke it into the corner, and the puck squirts free on left wing. Lyons steals, shoots one, and Dick just sets it up back of the net, and Kalamazoo play the puck. On the right side, the Wings take over, and the team from Michigan. The Messier plays to center, and Eagles Cruz able to bank it right back in.
Well, the Eagles are doing a great job of keeping the puck out of their own zone and into the wing zone, Mike.
Here is the forward Mario Tyre for Kalamazoo. Played college hockey at the University of Maine. Tries to play it free at the defense. Olsen ties him up. And finally, the Eagles, Kerry Clark, who's the big scorer tonight with 3 points, a goal and two assists. On right wing for Rich Turnamas. Into the wings territory. Cuts in the slot. Tries to work a three for Clark, but he bangs it wide. Clark has been outstanding here tonight along the boards and as far as the offense is concerned. There is the puck loose into the Kalamazoo end. The artful Sweeney after it, but finally the wings play it, but not out. And then finally it does squirt outside the blue line into center ice where Osiki able to push it right back into the wings territory. And Girard and plays it for Kalamazoo. Early on, third period, 6-1 Eagles, 2 minutes gone, into the final stanza. And Salt Lake's Paul Cruz tries to fling it to center, and the wings, Emmons, leave the play at three. Salt Lake's Cruz breaks it up, whirls around, plays for Osiki, and he cuts right back into the Kalamazoo zone. Drops for Hurkins a shot. Beck Karam's wide. At the left point, Lassard a shot. Stick save, Dick. And cleared by Kalamazoo into the center ice area. And boy, Lassard really can fire that puck.
Well, he's got a cannon. He was able to walk into that one, and Larry Dick had to make a super glove save.
Here's Todd Harkins, the native of Cleveland, Ohio. Tries to work it free to center, but blocked off for the defense. And Bruce Bell able to play it free for Larry DePalma at the left wing shot. He's a big, tough customer. Eagles take over, and Harkins drops it back for Deasley. And Deasley just spins it on the left wing side for the Soviet player, Sergei Priyakin. Here's Priyakin for the Salt Lake Golden Eagle. Able to whirl the center. He can skate. Left wing for Bureau. He's just got great strides as he works into the offensive zone. And Kalamazoo's Girard plays back to the net. Pokes it for Lappin on the right side. Lappin, the native of Chicago, tries to play it free deep into the Salt Lake territory. And Sharple sets it up for Olsen. No scoring so far in this third period.
Well, no scoring, but the Eagles don't want to get too fancy. They're content where they are right now.
Here's Bureau and across the line. Drops for Priyakin. Puck is loose at the blue line. And Mitch Messier gains possession. He's their leading point scorer for Kalamazoo. Frank Bureau and across the line, but a two-line offside. The pass coming from inside the Eagles' blue line to the Kalamazoo side of center.
Well, there we have the organist, Mike. Kind of a historic kind of thing. A lot of the new arenas are going to the rock and roll type of music. Well, there's a break in play, but the Salt Palace goes with the old organ, and she really stirs the crowd up, gets them on their feet and clapping their hands.
Joanne Harmon, a long time organist here at the Salt Palace, and I'm of the belief that you have to have the organ at the hockey game. Sure, you have the rock music, but I think when you think hockey, you think the organ.
Just think about the Chicago Stadium. Boy, they got the biggest pipe organ anywhere in hockey, I'm sure, and it sounds loud.
Here is Salt Lake's Olsen, tries to poke into the boards on left wing, and all the way into the Kalamazoo territory where Bruce Bell has to go back. Last year, Bell played at the Edmonton organization. Eagles to take over. Here is Deasley in front for Zemlak, and Dick gets a piece of that. Zemlak was cruising in the slot, and then it's wound by Kalamazoo to center, and Marco Siki swivels right back in. His pass picked off, and Dan Breton on left wing tries to play it right back on the far wing for Mitch Messier, and he's trapped in. He scores 6-1 Eagles, 15:58 left in the third period, and we'll be back in just a moment.
What's the shots, Mike, after two periods?
38:15. Back action here at the Salt Palace, and the fans have been treated to an outstanding show. The Eagles up 6-1, scoring 4 in the first and 2 more in the second period. And Warren Sharple sets it up for Kevin Grant, back of his net for the Salt Lake Golden Eagles. The second year full professional Grant, able to play it free on the left wing side. Kalamazoo in the forecheck. Courtney centers for Keaton. Shoots it right through the goal crease, but really not much mustard on the shot. Eagles trying to work it free. Kalamazoo play it at the blue line. And whipped to the side of the net with Mario Tyre, trying to center one, but Kerry Clark picks it off, and Rick Clark's been everywhere here tonight. However, Girard steals, shoots one, blocked by the defense, Sean Chambers for Kalamazoo, has to circle back. Eagles try and make a play, Sweeney all over Chambers, Turnamas after also, and finally, the Eagles captain lets it go for Kevin Grant, who leads Deasley, but blocked off in his center ice. Here's Deasley for the Golden Eagles, out of the University of Michigan, where Olsen cuts in, drop pass, he thought that Harkins was going to be there, he was not, And as a result, the Wings play it back to the net. Eagles trying to work it free, but Kalamazoo winds it to the blue line. Osiki jumps high in the air to try and make a play, but the Wings take over at center. Here's little Gary Emmons on right wing for Peter Lappin, cruising into the Salt Lake zone. Fires one off a stick and wide, and the Eagles play in their own side. Almost 6 minutes gone into the third period. The Eagles with a comfortable 6-1 lead. As the play in the Salt Lake end, Lappin after it. Right wing point, a chance for Joyce. His shot to bounces wide. Playing the Salt Lake end. Kalamazoo trying to whittle the lead. Here's Bell at the left wing point, holding on. Shoots one, and hits Deasley and bounces away, and then Deasley comes up with a puck.
Well, the Eagles are running around a little bit. They have to settle things down, gain control, and just play their positions.
Eagles change up offensively as Deasley jumps in. It's a shift change, and the new line out, Martin Samard with Sergei Priyankin and Mark Bureau. Bruce Bell, being hacked by Bureau, flips it right back into the Salt Lake territory where Lessard swirls back of his net. Here's Rick Lessard, played with the Ottawa 67s, junior hockey. Plays it to center, and then Dan Gratton plays it for Kalamazoo. Here is the player Gratton, a long shot, stick save, Sharples, and the puck rolls along the boards, and finally scores to center where Girard pounds it right back in. Offside, but 6:36 gone into the third period. A 6-1 Salt Lake lead. Warren Sharples looks for his 14th win of the year.
Well, he's been outstanding tonight. He's being called upon to make a couple of big saves, and he's been equal to the task every time except for once. Dainting, he won't be getting a shutout tonight. I suppose we can say shutout because neither goalie has a chance to get one.
Well, of course, Dan O'Halloran is taking it easy tonight, just 6 total minutes in penalties.
Well, he's starting to set a trend. Sometimes it's frustrating for the players when the referee doesn't whistle down penalties, and it causes a lot of animosity and some problems later on in the game. But two teams here that are willing just to play hockey, and we've seen a lot of action.
Eagles have Zemlak with Lyons and Samard as the faceoff will be deep into the Kalamazoo zone. They rule it was dropped unfairly, so they'll do it over again, Randy. They'll wait till both players are positioned in that face-off circle.
Well, of course, the linesman doesn't want to give either centerman any kind of an advantage to win the face-off, so that's why they're doing it again.
Eagles have Zemlak to drop against Steve Gonis, who played in the Pittsburgh organization, actually with Eagles backup goaltender Steve Cadet. Here is the puck cleared into center ice. Gonis after it. Long back on left wing where Chambers feeds for a streaking Gonis, but way out of the goal. Sharples to play it on the far wing. Bounces on edge with Girard plays. Shoots! And that deflects. May have gone off that crossbar or the goalpost. Here's the puck loose to the left wing side. Chambers unable to control, and it ricochets all the way to center.
Boy, Warren Sharples there getting a little bit of a break off of his friendly goalpost, Mike.
Here's Chambers on left wing. Goaltender's best friend, they say, as Gratton at center, bumped by Carey Clark. And then Clark rumbles after the loose puck. He and Gratton collide on the boards. There have not been a lot of big hits here tonight, although when there were in the first period, I think the Golden Eagles had most of them. Here's Grant now, able to shoot it right back into the Wings territory, and Clark able to work Grant in against Mario Tyre, trying to center one, but Bruce Bell plays it on the boards into the neutral zone. Eagles Osiki beautifully breaks it up in open ice, right wing for Chernomaz, but it's offside at the defense with 12:18 left in the third period. A 6-1 advantage in favor of the Salt Lake Golden Eagles, and there's the big hit with Carey Clark on the far wing with Dan Grant.
Boy, Carey Clark's on the score sheet, oddly enough, tonight with 3 points, but he's the big guy on this team. He throws his weight around, and he's a huge physical presence on that ice for this Golden Eagles team.
Players have to be pleased with their 5-goal cushion here in period three.
Well, they've worked hard to get that 5-goal lead, Mike, and they're still continuing to keep playing well in this third period.
Here is the puck cleared right back into the Eagles' end, and Warren Sharples himself wings it on the boards to the left wing side where Osiki spins back for Salt Lake. On the right side for Brian Deasley, and he's able to throw a pass across for Paul Cruz, but it's blocked off of the defense of Mario Tyre for Kalamazoo. Lines it free into the far side. Daryl Olson trying to dig it free. He and Courtney collide. They still try and kick it free to the right of the Eagles' net. And Salt Lake could play the puck, and Brian Deasley able to spin into center ice. Right side for Todd Harkins into the Kalamazoo end, but Dick himself plays it. Cruz breaks it up. Back of the goal for Harkins. He tries to make a play. It's kicked to the left of the goal. Harkins and Mario Tyre fight for it. They still try and fight along the boards in the Kalamazoo end. And finally, it's a work to Courtney, who slams it all the way down into the Salt Lake territory. Back after it is Kevin Grant icing is the call with 11:14 left. Third period here in Salt Lake. A 6-1 Eagle lead. We'll be right back in just a moment.
This is... Have you mentioned the shots on net at all?
Yeah, we did during the during that. I mentioned it. Okay. 38. Yeah.
Give me the scoring summary there, Mike.
Kalamazoo Wings and the Salt Lake Golden Eagles. The fans started the wave here tonight. They're pleased with the Salt Lake Golden Eagles' big lead. As the Wings take over at center, it's cleared right back into the Salt Lake end. Grant pushing Lappin off the puck and able to control for the Golden Eagles. 6-1 Salt Lake here midway through this third period as Paul Girard takes Richard Zemlak off the puck. As Randy, the fans cheering the Golden Eagles.
We're going to have a lot of fun here tonight, Mike.
Here's Emmons trying to maneuver in, tries to work it free, Lappin after it, shoots, and a kick save, Sharples, big rebound, loose in front, and taken by Kalamazoo's to Palma. Emmons now back to the net, centers one, and the only player there is Rick Lessard, who's just able to easily throw it to Rich Chernomaz in the center, crosses the blue line, right side for Zemlak, now goes, shoots, and a kick save by Dick as Zemlak let it fly. Chernomaz now at the blue line, cuts in, throws it for Zemlak, he's in on goal, but the defenseman Chambers breaks it up and Lappin, able to work the center for Kalamazoo. Right side for Paul Girard. His shot bounces off the backboards and Kalamazoo in a forecheck. This third period going by very quickly. Eagles up by 5 at 6-1 and Zemlak able to play at the center and Priyakin able to take possession for Salt Lake.
Boy, things couldn't have go better so far for the Eagles tonight. They're really stymieing the Kalamazoo Wings.
Here is Olsen now in across the line. Works in. Post checked at the blue line. And the former New York Ranger, Bruce Bell on right wing, paying for Mitch Messier, but beautifully taken off the puck by Kevin Melrose. He played the man very, very nicely along the board. Here's Bureau able to play at the center, and the defenseman Bell has to spin back for Kalamazoo. Sabat pounds him and then hits him against the boards to the delight of the hometown fans. The Eagles have thrown a couple of nasty checks during this third period. Osiki ahead for Bureau. The puck rolls off his stick, and he has to circle back at center. And the side slams it right back into the wing zone. Kalamazoo play it. Just over 9 minutes left in the third period. No scoring in this stanza. 6-1 Salt Lake lead. Here's Priyakin in on goal. Very good with the puck. He is able to swivel away from the checking of the player Tyre. Now back of the net. Priyakin still holding on. Shoots it. And a pad save. Dick. He holds on to that puck for a good 5 or 6 seconds as it's cleared deep into the Salt Lake zone. Lessard after it. And he just waits now to eat up some time. Touches it. Icing is the call. But my, oh my. Priyakin had the puck for a long time. And of course, Randy, as the play developed, an icing.
Well, the Wings probably iced the puck all the way down into the Eagles zone because they felt a lot of pressure on them and perhaps a little bit tired. So they wanted to change, throw it down. The Eagles touch it. Icing is called. The faceoff back in the wing zone.
A dejected Kalamazoo wing team. They will fly back, as will the Golden Eagles, to Kalamazoo, Michigan for the game tomorrow night. But right now, they're not feeling too good.
Well, things haven't gone well for them so far on this road trip here to Salt Lake. But the good thing about this sport of hockey is there's 82 games in the schedule, and tomorrow night's going to be a new night.
Eagles, Richard Zemlak with the Tim Sweeney and Kerry Clark up front. Kevin Grant and Kevin Melrose on defense, and Paul Girard for the Wings. Able to play it for J.F. Quintan on the right side for the forward Ed Courtney. Into the Golden Eagles zone. Squeezed off by Kevin Melrose. And how about Melrose? He's playing outstanding hockey in his own end.
Excellent, Mike. You don't have to throw a big check to be effective in your own zone. Just get yourself in between the puck carrier and the puck and eliminate him from making any kind of a play.
Now Melrose charges in across the line. Shoots, he scores! Kevin Melrose plays solid defense and then offensively breaks down the left wing side, snaps it behind Yarmo, or behind Larry Dick, in a 7-1 Salt Lake lead.
Well, Kevin Melrose comes flying down that left wing and just rips one, and Larry Dick wasn't able to squeeze his pads quite tight enough to hold that puck, and it just trickled in between him, his pads, and into the empty net. Melrose, a good head of steam up here, coming into the wing zone, has good momentum, and he just lets one fly. He's got a good wrist shot. He's a big, strong boy out of Red Deer, Alberta, worked on the farms, and he really ripped one and caught Larry Dick in between the legs.
Richard Zemlak and Kevin Grant on the assist. Kevin Melrose scoring his sixth goal of the year. He had a 3-point night Tuesday, so all of a sudden, he's becoming an offensive threat. Here is Paul Cruz after, but the defenseman Joyce plays it away. So Salt Lake with a 7-1 lead. Lead pass to Edgar Leary to Palm out of his reach. And Sharples himself plays it to the boards on the right side. Todd Harkins after it from the side for the Golden Eagles. Able to work out of there. Up the middle for Cruz. Bell breaks it up. And then able to play it free into the Salt Lake zone. The side ties a wing player up on the far side of the Golden Eagles, just taking the wings off the puck as soon as they get into the zone.
Well, they're really showing their muscle here tonight, Mike, just forcing the smaller wings team off the puck.
Here is Deasley now moving in. One against four green shirts, and he just tosses it right back behind the net. Eagles change up. They have Lyons and Zemlak up front on this line, and Kerry Clark as well. Here is Osiki now, able to work for Salt Lake in across that blue line. Osiki in front for Zemlak, but he can't pull the trigger as he was poke-checked at the last moment by Steve Gottes. And the Wings just poke it right back in the Eagles' territory with just over 7 minutes left in this game. Eagles with a 7-1 lead. They've outshot Kalamazoo 38-15 through two and have more shots in this third period. Here's the puck loose at center. Lyons after, but Messier on the point for Gottes. Cuts into the slot. In on goal. He stops. He shoots. Circles. Gets a pace. And into the far side. Gottes swings it behind the net for Dan Gratton. Centering pass off the mark. And Girard at the right point. Losing. Clark down the left wing side. Into the wing zone. One man back. He shoots it high. Over top of the net. All the way to center, and Gattis able to play it free for Girard. His shot going over top of the goal also. The Wings change up defensively, and Salt Lake play the puck. 6.5 minutes left in this game. Eagles have the only goal in this third period, a 7-1 lead. Mid Courtney down the right side. Moving in on goal with Stan shoots, and Sharples gets a pace up. Courtney shot, and the puck is loose into the corner. Olsen plays it back of the net. Puck bounces on edge. Courtney trying to center one. Loose in front, but Grant parades the slot and leads it for Samard on the right side. Left wing for Sergei Priyakin. Eludes a check. Scampers into the Kalamazoo zone. Tries to knock Bell off the puck. He tries to throw it down. Eagles after Priyakin for Samard. Priyakin after it also. Great puck handling into the Kalamazoo zone. The pass in front for Bureau a little bit off the mark with under 6 minutes left in this game. Eagles battling in the offensive zone. Wings play it to the blue line, and the Sard unable to hold it in as the puck squirts to center.
Well, great forechecking by the Eagles right now. They're really applying a lot of pressure.
Offside is the call at the Kalamazoo blue line with 5:38 to go in this game. Eagles up by six, and we'll come back in just a moment.
Oh, there's some guy mooning down there.
Here's play to the left of the goal, and we're going to have a penalty call on the far side. It looks like a high stick as Kalamazoo's Gary Emmons working into the offensive zone.
Well, very few penalties called throughout this game by Dan O'Halloran. But there's one of them, there's going to be a power play opportunity here, another 5-on-4 advantage. So they're, I think they could be asking for perhaps a 5-minute penalty against the Eagles player. If Emmons did draw blood, it's an automatic penalty. And there he is, there's his bloodied face. So that's going to be an automatic 5-minute high-sticking penalty. And alongside with that goes an automatic game misconduct, Rick Lessard being the victim. So he'll be lost for the rest of this game.
Now, as you mentioned, drawing blood as a result of 5-minute penalty, that's also a game misconduct.
Automatically, once there is a high-sticking infraction being called for a major penalty.
Well, we have a gentleman bringing a TV set to the game. And Randy, I want to thank our tremendous crew. They've done a nice job here tonight. It's a rarity to have hockey televised here in Salt Lake. Brian Douglas has done a great job. You know, this is a guy that has been more familiar with the hoops Carl Malone's and the John Stocktons, and boy, they're doing a great job here tonight.
Well, you'd never know it the way he's orchestrated everything around here. We've just had an easy time, and he's made everything really easy for us up here in the booth.
Face-off will be in the Salt Lake zone. Again, the penalty, Lessard, a high stick major and a game misconduct, 14-33. So for the basically the rest of this game, the Wings will have a power play, and they can score at will, although it's going to be very difficult to break a six-goal deficit. Salt Lake trying to work it free, but Kalamazoo come up with a puck for the run of the goal. Steve Gonis tries to jam it free. Noel throws down the Wings player, and the fans delighted about that. Here's Girard after it, and it finally squirts out the center, and Chambers swivels back for Kalamazoo.
Well, this Eagle team hasn't had a lot of chances to show their penalty-killing skills, but they've been outstanding in the past.
Eagles have a total of 16 shorthanded goals. Is among the leading totals in the IHL. Here's a chance for Kalamazoo's Messier, but squeezed off by Grant, and he himself plays it up into the stands to stop the play with 4:40 left in the third, 7-1 Eagles.
Now, one thing I want to point out, Mike, there's a big difference between the major penalty and the minor penalty, not only that it's 5 minutes as opposed to 2 minutes, but as you touched on before, during that five-minute span, the team can score as many goals as they can without the Eagles being able to get that man back out of the penalty box to boost it up to even strength. They'll stay shorthanded throughout the full 5 minutes.
And if it wasn't a 7-1 score, that could be a big factor in this game.
Could very well be, but with only 4:40 left on the clock, time's a factor, and with such a large margin between these two teams as far as the scoreboard go, it appears to be a little bit out of reach.
Here's a chance for Bruce Bell. Tries to work it for De Palma as he's being watched by Zemlak. Zemlak all over him. Drops to the point for Bell. His shot, pat save, Sharples, and then Grant able to backhand it out of harm's way and deep into the Wings territory.
Boy, Warren Sharples has really stepped forward in this third period. Didn't get a lot of action in the first two periods, but he's had to come up with some huge saves here in the third period to keep this Eagles lead at six goals.
3:47 left in the penalty. 4:12 left in the third period. A 7-1 Salt Lake advantage. Here is Kalamazoo's forward to Palma after Olsen plays it to the blue line, but the Wings hold it in. Joyce throws it across for the forward to Palma. Olsen all over him, and Bell plays at the right point. Here's Bruce Bell, smacks it right back behind the net. It bounces on edge. Lappin for Kalamazoo. Tries to work past Grant. Able to play it for Emmons as the Wings wheel and deal with the man advantage. Lappin cuts it on goal. Throws it across in front for the one-timer by De Palma. Fans on his shot. Now Emmons into the corner being watched by Eagles Kevin Grant. Bell now for Kalamazoo at the middle of the blue line on this power play with 3.5 minutes left in this game. Joyce now throws it to three to the point. Player on the far side, De Palma has lost his stick. He appears to be hurt, and Zemlak able to break out of there for Salt Lake.
Well, De Palma slowly going to the bench. He really caught a slash, I believe, off the stick of Kevin Grant, looking for another penalty, but referee Dan O'Halloran didn't see it, so he can't call what he doesn't see.
Here are the Wings taking control with just over 3 minutes left in this game. Ed Courtney able to break out of there. Free agent Minnesota player. Eagles Melrose picks an opening and plays it to the Salt Lake player's bench. With the 2:58 left, the 7-1 Salt Lake lead. We'll come back with more in just a moment from the Salt Palace.
Yeah, where's that roster? I got it right there on the wrist.
Dan Fox.
They don't have that on replay, do you?
I didn't see it.
We're back to action here at the Salt Palace. 2:54 left in this game. Eagles with a 7-1 lead. Seven different players have scored goals in this hockey game tonight, Randy, at the Salt Palace.
Well, a very balanced attack by this Golden Eagles team, and that's why they have so much success so far in this February, because they're not relying on any one person. The whole team is stepping forward, and they're all leaders, and that's why they're doing so well.
Mark Bureau for Salt Lake up front with Samar. Bureau leads the IHL with 7 shorthanded goals. Races after it himself into the wing zone with Samar, and a 2-on-1 breakthrough to Samar, but he can't control the pass across. Great 2-on-1 shorthanded bid. Now the Wings break out. Quintan moving in, but Osiki backchecks. and all he does is poke it away. And Bureau again into the wing zone with Samara. Bureau in on goal, trying to throw it back for Samara, but back checking is Chambers, and twice the Golden Eagles with offensive chances, although they're a man short. And Sharples himself able to swivel on the left wing side with the puck, and Melrose plays it for Salt Lake, picks an opening, and just shoots it all the way down.
Boy, how about this is a pretty solid Salt Lake Golden Eagles team right now. They're playing absolutely outstanding hockey, Mike.
Here's Ed Courtney for Kalamazoo. At center ice for Steve Gottes, Grant all over him, and then Priyankin spins back with just over 2 minutes left. Eagles with a 7-1 lead, and Kevin Grant able to play it up the middle for Salt Lake. Priyankin broken up on right wing. Messier's pass for Gottes off the mark. Eagles Priyankin trying to dig it free, and here he comes in his center ice. Works into the Kalamazoo zone, splits the defense, and on net he's in. He can't pull the trigger, but he's upended, and the Wings take over. A couple of shifty moves by the Soviet Sergei Priyankin.
This guy's incredible. The puck's on a string.
Here's Bella's shot deflects wide as the Wings on the attack. A minute and a half left in this game, just over a minute to go in the penalty, and Chernomaz able to break the center with Priyankin. Two on two and across the line. Chernomaz stops, pulls up, tries to center one, but the Wings break back on right wing. Here's Messier with just over a minute left in this game. Being hacked by Melrose, and then Hawkins slams it along the boards. It's cleared outside the blue line, and De Palma has to go back. Gets away from Cruz with just over a minute left in this game. 40 seconds to go on the penalty. Puck bounces around at center, and the Wings take over. Under a minute left in this game. Here's Emmons now for Kalamazoo. Whirling, throws it across, but it's shot over top of the net by De Palma. Up into the stands. We're down to 25 seconds left in the penalty. 52 seconds left. Warren Sharples looks for his 14th win of the year and his 7th straight in net for Salt Lake.
Well, he's done an absolutely outstanding job tonight, Mike, and he deserves a victory, and also only one goal against. He really deserves a shutout, but they were able to squeak one past him, but he's been absolutely outstanding throughout this full 60 minutes.
Well, I think the fans have really enjoyed it here tonight. A 7-1 win, over 6,000 here tonight, actually 6,600, so nearly 7,000 fans have been treated to just a solid, solid hockey game here tonight. Eagles return home for games March 12th and 14th against the Kansas City Blades, and you don't want to miss exciting IHL hockey. Here is Brian Deasley in the neutral zone for Tim Sweeney. One man back into the wing zone. Tries to work it for Deasley. Twirling around and then beautifully drops it back for Melrose with 40 seconds left.
Well, a great play by Deasley to flip it back to Melrose to kill some time on that clock.
Eagles take over with 30 seconds to go, and they rookie Osiki able to play the puck on left wing into center ice, and Sweeney gains the puck for Salt Lake and just skies it into the corner with 20 seconds to go. Chambers for Kalamazoo on the wing for De Palma. De Palma now with 15 seconds left for Emmons. Right side left and fires, caught by Sharples, and he holds on with a couple of green shirts in front. And how about that? Warren Sharples stops Peter Lappin for about the fourth time that I had a racket into the Eagle zone.
Boy, this Kalamazoo team must be very frustrated. They've had limited scoring opportunities, but Warren Sharples, through his great focus and awareness of this game, has really stymied them, and they must be frustrated, Mike.
Well, the Eagles are looking for win number 38. They are 15 games over the 500 mark. They will move to 38, 22, and 5. We have 9 seconds left. Eagles trying to work it free, but the Wings take over at the point. Flicked down by Bell. 3 seconds left. 2-1. The game is history. The Salt Lake Golden Eagles all out to congratulate Warren Sharples, his 14th win of the year. The Golden Eagles, their 38th win, and the Golden Eagles pick up points in every game in the month of February.
Well, the Golden Eagles continue to roll, Mike. Hopefully, I don't want to say this, but hopefully they're not peaking too soon. The playoffs are a little ways away, but they've really got things going in the right direction, and hopefully they can carry it on in through April when the playoffs start.
Golden Eagles encircling Warren Sharples, who again picks up the win here tonight for the Salt Lake Golden Eagles. And we're going to go down to ice level with Mike Runge and head coach Bob Francis.
Thank you very much, Mike Barrick. Another win for the Golden Eagles. And Bob, you can have these guys. They are playing so well right now against some of the high-powered, high-scoring teams in the International Hockey League.
Yeah, Mike, and the encouraging thing is we generated a lot of offense and we still had the commitment defensively. And I know we shut them down fairly well. We got better as the game went on, and the encouraging thing, as I say again, is that We're getting our offensive results and paying a price defensively.
You go on the road now and you play Kalamazoo in Kalamazoo. Will that game change a lot from the way Kalamazoo played tonight, Bob, do you think?
Well, they play well at home, and we can't get caught up in an open style of game against Kalamazoo. They have a lot of skill up front, and we have to keep it tight defensively and generate and attack their zone with a lot of speed and get it deep on the odd occasion, force their D to get back for it, and it'll allow us to get in their zone off the rush.
You can't get too cocky because we still have plenty of games to go in the rest of the year, but right now there isn't a team in the league that's playing any better than the Golden Eagles.
Well, it's getting scary, Mike. You don't want to say anything because as hard as it works to get to this point, you can lose it just like that. But 30 games left in the season, we had a discussion. It's a process. We wanted to get better, better, so come playoff time, we're going to allow ourselves the best opportunity.
Bob, good luck on the road, and we'll see you when you get back in town.
Thanks, Mike.
Head coach Bob Francis of the Salt Lake Golden Eagles. Back up to you, Mike Barrick.
Randy Busick, a 7-1 Salt Lake lead. What a month for the Salt Lake Golden Eagles.
Well, you couldn't have written a better script for them. They played absolutely outstanding, as Bobby Francis said. They really have the commitment. They're playing well, and they're continuing to roll along.
7-1 the final here tonight. For Randy Busick, I'm Mike Barrack. A solid Salt Lake win. We'll be right back in just a moment. Yeah.
Sure.
Get the final shots if they could I didn't hear the final shots there in the third. Shoot. I don't have my earphone on. Dad,
did you hear the final shots?
40-23, we had 38 through 2.
40-23,
Brian.
Where it was 38-23. Yes, I can hear you.
30 seconds.
So we will take another break and just tap for about 30 seconds. 40 seconds. Okay. Welcome back, everybody, to the Salt Palace. A solid victory for Salt Lake, 7-1. Here tonight, the Salt Lake Golden Eagles over the Kalamazoo Wings. And Randy Busick, the Salt Lake Golden Eagles continue to fly high.
Well, this is a team that's having a lot of fun right now. As Rich Chernomaz said before, they enjoy coming to the rink and they enjoy posting numbers like they did tonight. And if they continue to play well, they have nothing but success in front of them.
14-0-1 in the month of February.
Absolutely amazing for a team to be able to compile statistics like that. But that's because they're working as a group and they're playing very well together, Mike.
Well, Randy, it was a great win tonight for the Salt Lake Golden Eagles, and we'll come back for a final word in just a moment. 7-1 the final here tonight at the Salt Palace.
Okay, you don't need me anymore then, right, Brian?
Okay.
similar leasing programs.
How'd it go, by the way?
Plus a myriad of other similar financial
go
services.
Go pretty well tonight, Brian.
So when it comes to business banking, how do you choose a bank that'll may we suggest you look to the one who stands out?
Welcome back to the Salt Palace. The final score tonight, Salt Lake 7 and Kalamazoo 1. The Eagles play 15 games in the month of February and pick up points in all 15. Golden Eagles return home March 12th. They'll take on the Kansas City Blades here at the Salt Palace. Want to thank all the people from KXIV Sports who helped to make this broadcast possible here tonight. Golden Eagles and the Kalamazoo Wings, 7-1 the final here tonight. So long, everybody.